Got the door. Door's on. Tub's in.
Back roads. that truck for a while. The guy had it at his shop. Obviously, needed some parts off of it, but didn't have a title. And it being a 2005, needed the title to get rid of it. So, waited for a while, a couple months, called me up, finally got it. So he said, I want to get this thing out of there. Of course, somebody already had at the Cats a long time ago. So, don't buy vehicles with no cats. That's my policy. So he just wanted it gone, and wouldn't have been too heavy missing. The engine was in there. It's actually still good. I actually heard it run before, but don't have the time or really the desire to pull it out. No transmission or transfer case in it. And obviously you saw that there was no rear end. No tailgate. And no driver's seat. Hold on, this might be a cop. Nope. So many Ford Explorers up here. Headlights, but yeah, so I like when things work out, because I had one guy down the street had some scrap in his yard, he wanted gone, so I got that, put that in there. It's actually a bunch of copper and some wire. I obviously separated that, added it to my stockpile, but that other stuff you saw me pick up. Some light iron, you know, appliances and stuff. That's just part of my service. I don't charge to pick that stuff up, but I really should. So I was able to put all that in the truck, and nice to be able to get rid of all of it at once, rather than just have to take in a light load of a light, you know, just light iron. For some reason that truck was still too heavy in the front, and it's one thing I hate is having to tow him backwards, but where he had the truck sitting, he had it blocked up in the back, and there's no way to get it from the front, so had to drag it on, and we had to cut the trailer hitch off with the torch so we could pull it, you know, further ahead on my trailer, because it front tires of the truck were right on the edge. So, but it was too tail heavy still, and I hate when I have to do that, because it's a bad ride. People don't understand that tail's wagging all over the place when you got too much weight back there. You want the weight on the tongue on the front. And I added all that scrap to the back bed, and still couldn't go over 40 miles an hour or else it started wagging. So couldn't take the interstate, had to take the back roads. So it makes for a long day. You gotta take the back roads all the way there. It's over 2 hours. Plus, I got a late start because I had to go mess around and get that truck on there, and then, you know, put all the metal in there and stuff. Then, on my way there, I stopped and said, you know, better just look under the hood. There's probably no battery, nothing, but there was actually a battery in there, an AC Delco side post, so still good. We left it in there, so I had to take that out. So just because I'm a nice guy, he had four aluminum wheels with tires. He wanted to, he asked me how much they pay for them, and I told him I'd bring them down there and sell them for him. So that's what those were, and I'll just give him the money for those. not too bad, even though that truck, I don't know how much it would weigh from the factory, but it's, you know, a four-wheel drive, regular cab, V8, you know, truck. I mean, I don't know what the current weight is, but like I said, no transmission, no transfer keys, no rear end, no tailgate or driver's seat, and it weighed, still weighed 4,800 pounds. With all the stuff that I put in there, so not too bad of a load for the day. Took up most of my day. Sun is set down. It's already getting dark. I had to skip through lunch. No lunch today. So no celebration. No chili. But hopefully make it home before dinner time.